Today we're going to be designing and then assembling a sunglasses holder or a sunglasses shelf. Now the first thing we need to understand prior to cutting the wood and assembling the shelf is how much space does each shelf need to hold all the pairs of sunglasses that we have available. The easiest way to do this if you already have your sunglasses on hand is to line them all up physically on either a piece of cardboard or in this case a piece of paper and then put the bounding constraints around them to show the minimum size shelf you will need to hold all of your sunglasses. I already have all my sunglasses on hand, so I'm gonna go ahead and proceed with that now so we can determine what size shelf we need to make. At this point, I've counted how many total pairs of sunglasses that I want to be able to store on the shelf. I've made a line that'll capture the biggest size of sunglasses that I have, so that way I know that all of my sunglasses will fit on these shelves. I also did a rough height measurement while I had all the sunglasses here. I put the ruler straight up and then put my thumb where the approximate height was. That way I would know all the shelves were tall enough to physically slide the sunglasses in. We have to see how big the space that these are going to go into is. That way we know we're not exceeding the spatial limitations of where this will be hung. Now the current plan is to hang this in the closet in the master bedroom, which is still very small. Thought is I'll hang it here on the left wall between the actual door frame and the shirts that are hanging up. Now taking our tape measure, we can see we have approximately 10 inches of space, maybe 10 and a half inches of space between the door frame and the actual shirts. We don't want to take up that entire space, otherwise we'll be up against both the door frame and the shirts when we hang up the actual hanger. If we try to get a height measurement using the tape measure, we have about 32 inches of total space. However, if we use that entire space, we're going to be touching both this lower and this upper side rail bar. So that's really not gonna look good if we use the entirety of that area. Having figured out the constraints for both the size of the sunglasses and the space I wanted to put the sunglasses hanger in, I then went back and forth with a lot of the dimensions to see how much extra space I wanted to help maneuver the sunglasses to make it easier to get them in and out of the hanger versus how much space I had for the area. What I ultimately decided on doing was paring it down to only have 8 pairs of sunglasses on the shelf, and that really helped me out with the height. The other major change I had to account for was the depth of these was originally going to be the 3.5 inches because of those 1x4 side rails, and I decided that was too deep for the space I was going to have and it would be really in your face and obtrusive once you open the closet. For that reason, I decided to slim down those M boards as well to reduce that depth. I'll make a separate video for the build and final dimensions and I'll link that in the description below.
Now I've already played around a bunch with the different designs that I was looking at making. I played around with a lot of the sizing and how I wanted to assemble it, and I looked at how big my actual sunglasses were and how many pairs I wanted to hang. And from all of that, what I got was the final dimensions that I had and the finished product that I wanted to achieve.
I adjusted these values in the actual build process, so the correct values will be in that link in the description below.
The shelf is now complete. I'm pretty happy for the most part with how it came out. There's a few small gaps at some of the edges that I'm not thrilled about, but they're not bad enough that it's worth redoing. Coming up into the closet, this is the space I originally had this planned for, and it actually fits just about perfectly. So that said, let's get a hanger on the back of this, and let's get it in the wall. Looking again at where I wanted to hang this, I did check again if I have any studs in the area that I could go through the back panel of that sunglasses rack and then straight into a stud. Even though I really don't think there's enough weight to justify needing a stud, it would just be more of a convenience thing. But all the studs are either directly in that corner or about, you know, a third of the way into these shirts, so that's really not an option. So what I'm gonna do to hang this instead, I'm gonna put a mount in the back of each of the 1x4s that were on the edge, and I'm gonna run a wire between them, then put a picture frame hanger. And I was a little worried about the profile of this, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna bend it in so it doesn't stick out as much, and then that way the back won't be too angled, or at least won't be angled enough that it's noticeable and annoys me.
After installing that wire on the back of the sunglasses shelf, I then bent down the tab on the picture frame hanger to lower over the profile, put it into the wall, hung up the sunglasses shelf, and then moved all my sunglasses over.
And with that, sunglasses hanger is complete and the closet reno is one step closer to being absolutely finished. That's all I got for this episode. Thanks for watching.